In the beginning was
the Word, and the Word was
with God,
and the Word was God.
The Word was in the beginning
with God.
All things came into being.
Through the Word,
without the Word,
not one thing came into being. What has come into being in the Word was life.
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 Life, and the life was the light of all people.
The light shines in the darkness,
but the darkness.
And the darkness did not overcome it.
The true light, which enlightens everyone, was coming into the world.
True light into the world. And the light was in the world, and the world came into being through the Word.
Yet the world did not know the Word.
The Word came to their own people, and the people did not accept the Word. But to those who received the Word, who believed in the Word,
received the power to become the children of God, who were born
not of blood,
or the will of flesh,
or of the will of humankind,
but of God. And the Word became flesh and lived among us, and we have seen the glory of the Word,
the Christ child,
the glory of God Most High,
full of grace and truth.
And we receive the light of Christ this night, the holiest of nights, into our hearts.
Thank you. You may be seated. Well, good evening, everyone. Welcome to East Church. My name is Reverend Lori Curley, and I want to welcome you to our wonderful Lessons and Carols service this evening. If you did not pick up a candle on the way in, we have ushers ready to get you one. If you need, please raise your hand, if so. Well, everyone's been really good. All right. Oh, thank you. I want to welcome you this evening. If you are visiting with us, please fill in the friendship pads that are in the inner packet of the aisle, by the aisle, to let us know that you've been with us. If you wish to be on our email list and get information about the church during the year, please give us your email address. We welcome you for that. Our regular services are at 10:30 on Sunday mornings. I also want to let you know that we are taking an offering tonight. There's no formal part in the service for that offering, but all offering tonight will be going to Family Promise, which is an organization that we support through the Interfaith Hospitality Network. Try to get that out. Which is, they do transitional housing for families that are getting out of homelessness and back into regular housing. And we support that ministry. And some of the money will also go to our local food pantry here in the building. We want to welcome you and thank you for being with us tonight as we celebrate the birth of Jesus our Lord. Let us continue now in our worship. Let us pray. Holy God of love, there is light in our lives because of the abundance of your steadfast love, a love so vast, so deep, so real, that you became as one with us. May we live within the power of this love, and may we share its light with the world where too many dwell in darkness. May the spirit and power of peace prevail in the name of Christ, whose birth we celebrate tonight. Amen.
Please be seated. Our first reading comes from the 12th chapter of Genesis, verses 1 through 5. Now the Lord said to Abram, "Go from your country and your kindred and your father's house to the land that I will show you. I will make of you a great nation, and I will bless you and make your name great, so that you will be a blessing. I will bless those who bless you, and the one who curses you, I will curse. And in you all the families of the earth shall be blessed." So Abram went as the Lord had told him, and Lot went with him. Abram was 75 years old when he departed from Haran. Abram took his wife Sarai and his brother's son Lot and all the possessions that they had gathered and the persons whom they had acquired in Haran, and they set forth to go to the land of Canaan. This is the word of God for the people of God.
Thanks.
Our second reading comes from the 9th chapter of Isaiah, verses 2, 6, and 7. The people who walked in darkness have seen a great light. Those who lived in a land of deep darkness, on them light has shined. For a child has been born for us, a child given to us. Authority rests upon their shoulders and is named Wonderful Counselor, Mighty God, Everlasting Holy One, Prince of Peace. The child's authority shall grow continually, and there shall be endless peace for the throne of David and kingdom. They will establish and uphold it with justice and with righteousness from this time onward and forevermore. The zeal of the Lord of hosts will do this. This is the word of God for the people of God.
Thank you.
Our third reading comes from the fifth chapter of Micah, verses 2 through 5a. But you, O Bethlehem of Ephrathah, you who are one of the little clans of Judah, from you shall come forth for me one who is to rule in Israel, whose origin is from of old, from ancient days. Therefore, God shall give them up until the time when the one who is in labor has brought forth. Then the rest of their kindred shall return to the people of Israel, and they shall stand and feed the flock in the strength of the Lord, in the majesty of the name of the Lord God. And they shall live secure, for now the one shall be great to the ends of the earth, and they shall be the one of peace. This is the word of God for the people of God.
Our fourth reading this evening is a reenactment from the first chapter of Luke, verses 26 through 38. In the sixth month, the angel Gabriel was sent by God to a town in Galilee called Nazareth, to a virgin engaged to a person whose name was Joseph of the house of David. The virgin's name was Mary. And the angel came to her and said,
"Greetings, favored one, the Lord is with you."
But Mary was much perplexed by their words and wondered what sort of greeting this must be.
"Do not be afraid, Mary, for you have found favor with God. And now you will conceive in your womb and bear a child, and you will call them Jesus. He will be great, and he will be called the Anointed One of the Most High. And the Lord God will give to him the throne of David. He will reign over the house of Jacob forever, and of his kingdom there shall be no end."
"But how can this be, since I am a virgin?"
"The Holy Spirit will come upon you, and the power of the Most High will overshadow you. Therefore, the child to be born will be holy. He will be called the child of God. And now, your relative Elizabeth, in her old age, who has also conceived a child, and this is the sixth month for her who is said to be barren, for nothing will be impossible with God."
"Here am I, the servant of the Lord. Let it be with me according to your word."
And then the angel departed from her. Together, this blessed Christmas Eve, we respond with Mary's Magnificent.
My soul magnifies the Lord. And my spirit rejoices in God my Savior, for God has looked with favor on the lowliness of their servant. Surely, from now on, all generations will call me blessed, for the Mighty One has done great things for me, and holy is the name of the Lord. God's mercy is for those who fear God from generation to generation. This is the word of God for the people of God. Thanks be to God.
Our fifth reading comes from the second chapter of Luke, verses 1 and 3 through 7. In those days, a decree went out from Emperor Augustus that all the world should be registered. All went to their own towns to be registered. Joseph also went from the town of Nazareth in Galilee to Judea, to the city of David called Bethlehem, because he was descended from the house and family of David. He went to be registered with Mary, to whom he was engaged and who was expecting a child. While they were there, the time came for her to deliver her child. And she gave birth to her firstborn and wrapped him in bands of cloth and laid him in a manger, because there was no place in the inn. This is the word of God for the people of God. Thanks be to God.
Thank you. sixth reading comes from the second chapter of Luke, verses 8 through 16. In that region, there were shepherds living in the fields, keeping watch over their flock by night. Then an angel of the Lord stood before them, and the glory of the Lord shone around them, and they were terrified. But the angel said to them, "Do not be afraid, for see, I am bringing you good news of great joy for all the people. To you is born this day in the city of David a Savior, who is the Messiah, the Lord. This will be a sign unto you. You will find the child wrapped in bands of cloth and lying in a manger." And suddenly there was with the angel a multitude of the heavenly hosts, praising God and saying, "Glory to God in the highest heaven, and on earth peace among those whom God favors." When the angels had left him and gone into heaven, the shepherds said to one another, "Let us go now to Bethlehem and see this thing that has taken place, which the Lord has made known to us." So they went with haste and found Mary and Joseph and the child laying in the manger. This is the word of God for the people of God. Thanks be to God.
Our seventh reading comes from the second chapter of Matthew, verses 1 through 11. In the time of King Herod, after Jesus was born in Bethlehem of Judea, wise men from the east came to Jerusalem, asking, "Where is the child who has been born King of the Jews? For we have observed a star at its rising, and we have come to pay homage." When King Herod heard this, he was frightened, and all Jerusalem with him, and calling together all of the chief priests and scribes of the people, he inquired of them where the Messiah was to be born. They told him, "In Bethlehem of Judea, for so it has been written by the prophet. And you, Bethlehem, in the land of Judah, are by no means the least among the rulers of Judah, for from you shall come a ruler who is to be shepherd my people Israel." Then Herod secretly called for the wise men and learned from them the exact time when the star had appeared. Then he sent them to Bethlehem, saying, "Go and search diligently for the child. And when you have found the child, bring me word so that I may also go and pay homage." When they had heard the king, they set out. And there ahead of them went the star that they had seen at its rising, until it stopped over the place where the child was. When they saw that the star had stopped, they were overwhelmed with joy. On entering the house, they saw the child with Mary, his mother, and they knelt down and paid homage. Then, opening their treasure chests, they offered him gifts of gold, frankincense, and myrrh. This is the word of God for the people of God. Thanks be to God.
We heard tonight, for a child has been born for us, a son given to us. Authority rests upon his shoulders, and his name shall be Wonderful Counselor, Mighty God, Everlasting One, Prince of Peace. His authority shall grow continually, and there shall be endless peace from the throne of David and his kingdom. These are the words of the great prophet Isaiah, spoken centuries before the birth of Jesus. A prince, an heir to a throne, and not just any throne, the throne of David? No, the throne of God, the everlasting one. This wonderful prophecy proclaimed the coming of the kingdom of God to be established here on earth, a kingdom to bring peace and wisdom to the world. So one would expect a new future king to be born somewhere noble or powerful, in a castle or in a famous city. But instead, we have two ordinary people, a couple, being required by an occupying force to travel nearly 100 miles to be counted. Counted as a descendant of a forgotten royal line that is praised by Isaiah. To be counted so that more oppressive acts of taxation and occupation could be inflicted upon their people by an occupying ruler, by Caesar of Rome, the false prince of peace. A Caesar promised peace, but his peace was secured through dictatorship and an oppressive military presence. They called it Pax Romana, the peace of Rome. And Luke starts off this gospel with these two strong images of two different kingdoms. One of the mighty kingdom of Rome, the empire, and the other of a forgotten, fallen kingdom of David. One offering Pax Romana, and the other fulfilling the promises of a prophet long ago named Isaiah, promising a prince of peace from David's royal line. A simple, unknown child, born not in a castle or laid upon silken linens, but one simply born to a simple couple, unknown, in an obscure shelter on the edge of town, perhaps, in a little town called Bethlehem. This birth story ends with these words, "And she gave birth to her firstborn son and wrapped him in bands of cloth and laid him in a manger because there was no place in the inn." Luke's story only tells us that there was no room for him in the inn. We imagine that they were turned away harshly. But what if the manger and this barn, perhaps, was really a creative solution to a terrible problem? They were offered an overlooked dwelling to the house in order to house the holy, giving them hope, giving them shelter and hope. Perhaps they were also offered a seat at the table, a place of peace, and a moment of tranquility and fellowship, nourishing their souls and their bodies. They were offered things that they also needed for this birth and to stay warm where they were at. Strangers giving joyfully from their belongings so that this family would not go without. And finally, comes that night. For 9 months, Mary has lovingly been the house, the first inn, for Jesus. And Jesus is born out of that place of love into a world longing for peace. And Jesus is received in the arms of loving parents as he begins his reign of peace. Peace not given by power or might, but peace given by God's eternal and everlasting love and forgiveness of sins. Tonight we celebrate the humble and unusual beginnings of this Prince of Peace, Jesus' birth, and prepare our hearts to be the dwelling place of the Prince of Peace. Jesus seeks not a palace or a building built with hands and stone, but the human heart to be the dwelling place of God's kingdom here on earth. Are we ready to receive the Prince of Peace in our hearts once again? Are we ready to make room for the Holy to dwell within us? This reign of peace does not stop here, but continues out beyond these walls in the actions of you and I. Are we ready to be a source of hope to those who are seeking shelter from this harsh world? Are we able to welcome the stranger to a table of peace, to nourish them with the bread of life given by Jesus? Are we willing to share from the abundant blessings that God has given to us so that their hearts may be filled with joy and know the joy of salvation and love of God? Are we willing to see Christ birthed once again through our love for those that are longing for peace and a place of welcome? That is why we celebrate this wonderful, wonderful night. We celebrate Christ's birth because it was not just a birth hundreds of years ago. No, it is a birth that continues this day in the hearts of each and every one of us, that opens our hearts to receive Christ again. We continue the legacy of this holy night by becoming the indwelling of the Spirit of God into our hearts. I invite all of us to welcome the true Prince of Peace into our hearts once again as we house the holy. And may we, along with this congregation, be a place of welcome and love and care for those who seek hope, peace, joy, and love. May we be a place of shelter to welcome those out of this harsh world into a sanctuary full of God's love and grace. This is the word of God for the people of God. Thanks be to God. Let us pray. Holy Living One, you showed up in our midst in the most unlikely way, in the most unlikely place. Come to us now in our need. Surprise us by showing up in our trembling voices, in our aching hearts, in our uncertain futures. Birth in us a rugged hope, an unsurpassed peace, an illogical joy, and an infull of love. We pray this in the precious name of the Holy Infant. Come to set us free. Amen. Tonight we celebrate the light of Christ coming into the world, and we are charged with the call of Christ to carry this light out into the world, to proclaim the glory of God to the people who stand in darkness, who long for the love of God in their lives. Go and spread the light of Christ.
In the distance, call in the night, unwind you, enfold us, you speak of the light. Gentle on the ear, you whisper softly, rumors of a dawn embrace.
bright shepherds and kings from afar. Shimmer in the sky, so empty, lonely, rising in the warmth of your son's love. Star unknowing of night and day, Spirit, we wait for your loving Son.
Of the light in this night. One candle is but a flicker, but together we create a bright flame of Christ's light into the world. Jesus is the hope of all of our tomorrows. May we be witnesses of the light that Christ brings. We carry the light of Christ in our hearts into the world as testimony to the love of God that has entered the world this night. This holy night, may you feel God's presence with you. May you know Christ as sure and powerful as a light in the shadows. And may you feel the Spirit use you to be seeds of grace for a waiting world. Christ is born. We carry the light of Christ into the night to show others the way, faith. Thanks be to God. Amen.